When it comes to cartoons, we all have beloved cartoon characters we loved since our childhood and continue to love more and adore as we get older. Of course, there are cartoon characters you can't stand and drives you nuts. Without further ado, here's my top 15 most hated cartoon characters. Let's get started.
Look, I found her red coat and your bitch caught out there.
I hate you so much right now. I hate you so much right now.
Starting off at number 15, Uncle Grandpa. Usually main characters are the likable ones, but when it comes to Uncle G, not so much. Sure, he's nice, friendly, cares for children, and he always comes to a child's aid. The thing is, I find Uncle G very annoying. When he talks, he sounds like a mentally challenged walrus talking with a mouthful of food. When he says his "good morning" catchphrase so much repetitively. What also pisses me off about him is when he looks up to Pizza Steve like he's a hero, some oh-so-cool radical guy who's awesome, but really isn't. In the Brain Game episode, Uncle G was close to realizing that Pizza Steve is not the guy he thought he always was when questioning his video game skills.
"I'm beginning to wonder if you're telling me the truth about your video game skills. In fact, I'm beginning to wonder if you're telling me the truth about anything."
Geez, Uncle Grandpa, you're finally realizing that and wondering? About time. I loved how Pizza Steve's fake ass was just silent, and he was just sweating all over his piece of face, because he knew he was gonna be dead meat. Good. I like seeing you like that, Pizza Steve. So of course Pizza Steve had to prove that he's no liar by showing Uncle G his video game skills, which Uncle G of course believed him, since no surprise Pizza Steve did it. It's like, will you get it through your big letter L shaped of an empty headed skull and realize Pizza Steve is not the guy you think he is? Man! I'd rather have Aunt Grandma have her own show instead of him. I like how Aunt Grandma hates him, plus her voice is heavenly to listen. She's cute and a foxy red-headed pigtails wearing woman. Oh, I love me some Aunt Grandma. Uncle G talking about, "I'm cute." Not with that voice, you're not. Boy, I tell you, I got a kick out of that second Uncle Grandpa Weird Man short where Uncle Grandpa asked Mr. Gus and Pizza Steve if they wanted to read Weird Man with them. Oh, man. I lost it when they both left the RV. Oh, man. It was so hilarious.
"Hey, Mr. Gus. Hey, Pizza Steve. You guys want to read Weird Man with me? So what do you say, you want to read Weird Man with me?"
"Oh, hell no, Uncle Grandpa. I don't read that Weird Man gobbledygook."
"Yeah, no offense, Uncle G, but Pizza Steve doesn't get down with Weird Man.
That guy is just plain weird."
I put Uncle Grandpa at number 15 because he's not as hated as the other characters on my list. Even though I don't care for the show, nor find it that funny, but at the end of that one episode, In the Clouds episode, that I saw that one Saturday because I had nothing else to watch, when Uncle Grandpa was trying to get something off of the one kid's mom's face, turned out to be a freckle. But Uncle G just kept trying to get it off. That was the first time I ever laughed at the show. It's like, dude, it's a freckle. It's not coming off. Give it up. Number 14, The Annoying Orange. What's more to say? He's annoying, with an annoying laugh, telling annoying jokes. He laughs at his own jokes while the other fruits don't find him funny at all. They're like, all right, enough, you're not funny. He's just not funny at all. He's just annoying Everything about him is annoying. That's why he's the annoying orange. FYI, those human-like eyes and mouth don't help. That goes for the rest of the fruits. Thank goodness Cartoon Network got rid of the annoying orange. What were they thinking? Number 13, Jimmy Pesto Sr. of Bob's Burgers, also Bob's rival. This guy is a complete asshole, always trying to outshine Bob, trying to convince people to come to his restaurant and not Bob's. Just constantly harassing Bob. Will you leave Bob alone? It was also messed up in the season 6 finale episode of Bob's Burgers, glued Where's My Bob, which I will review even though it's late, sorry. He enjoys Bob's misery, telling the news Bob's personal business about him being glued to the toilet. It's bad enough Bob's life is a living hell. Why would you make it worse, asshole? Asshole! He's just mad since he knows his food stinks, while Bob's is better. Bob Belcher always wins, Jimmy Pesto Sr. Always! So deal with it! Number 12, Kevin of Ed, Edd n Eddy. The guy is such an annoying jerk. Gets the kick out of calling the Eds dorks and losers. He literally enjoys pounding them and seeing them get tortured. All I have to say is, this big chin, three hairs on his head fool is a dork himself. He's the true dork, not the Eds. Also, he's a punk. Punk! Number 11, Tara of Teen Titans Go. In the original Teen Titans, Tara was the cool, laid-back chickadee, even though she was insecure. But in Teen Titans Go, she's an evil, mean bitch who wants to destroy the Titans. We all know Beast Boy and Tara had a thing for each other in the original Teen Titans series as well. Beast Boy still does in the Teen Titans Go series, but Tara doesn't have feelings for him, as she hates and uses him for the wrong, evil reasons. Not to mention manipulating him. I guess that's Teen Titans Go's way of shitting on Beast Boy and Tara fans, just like how the show shits on Robin and Starfire fans. I wish Beast Boy would have realized and would have gotten through his empty skull of a head sooner that Tara hates him. But I guess he was blinded by love. You mean he couldn't realize Tara despised him whenever she threw a big rock at him? Not to mention, even though Beast Boy won Tara over with that fadeaway song, apparently she broke up with Beast Boy because Beast Boy repeatedly sang the same song over and over and over again. You can't fade away, you can't fade away. To the point that Tara just lost it and she decided to just break up with him because he couldn't think of any other songs. You mean to tell me Beast Boy couldn't come up with other songs about Tara? That's not about the same old repetitive fadeaway song? I mean, come on, Beast Boy. You're better than that. I mean, if you keep singing the repetitive song over and over again, she's going to grow tired of it and she's not going to like it anymore and she's not going to like you anymore. Because of that, you lost the girl of your dreams. But you know what? You're better off. Tara in this series, like I said, is just a total bitch who just treats people like crap. So she ends up with Aqualad. Beast Boy and Raven? Hey, it was great seeing them ruin their relationship. And it was so funny seeing Tara falling into Raven's portal trash hole full of trash. Especially the third time with Aqualad. I mean, I felt bad that Aqualad ended up falling in the portal with Tara, but it was so refreshing and so funny seeing Tara end up in the that trash hole for the third time. She was like, no, not the trash hole again. Yeah, stay down there, Tara. But she did not, because she returned in the Operation Do Rescue Part 1 and 2 episode, where Starfire, Jinx, Rose, even Raven had no clue Terra had a plan to trap them. Even when it came to Terra's evil laugh and rubbing her hands together. You mean to tell me they couldn't tell that she was up to no good, where they could come up with a plan to trap Terra before she would trap them? How could they not see that? How could Raven not see that one coming? I thought she was the smart one. I can expect this crap from Starfire, but not Raven. Heck, I didn't even think Rose and Jinx this gullible not to see that Terra was up to no good. It's like, how could Raven, Rose, and Jinx not see this one coming? What the heck? F Team Titans Go Terra. Team Titans Terra always. I want the original Terra in the Teen Titans Go series instead. Well, this has been part 1 of my top 15 most hated cartoon characters. Stay tuned for part 2 as I count down my last top 10 most hated cartoon characters. I hope you enjoyed. See ya.
Last year, Valentine's Day, you would just want me to say, babe, I love